Welcome to the part 2 of the PLC programming tutorial. If you have seen the part 1 of this video tutorial, we have written the ladder logic program to generate a timeout alarm for the conveyor belt. In case you haven't seen the part 1, the link is in the description. Please go and check out the first part to have the better understanding about this video tutorial. At the end of the part 1, I have discussed a programming error in this ladder logic. The problem was that the timeout timer is only getting activated if the conveyor motor fault occurs and a rotating cam is not in front of the sensor I0.1. But wait, what if the conveyor belt fault occurs and it stops when the cam is right in front of the sensor I0.1? As we have used the normal close contact of the sensor I0.1, when the cam is in front of this sensor I0.1, this normal close contact will get opened up and it will disable the timeout timer. So now we need to figure out how we can generate the timeout alarm even if the conveyor belt gets malfunctioned when the cam is in front of the sensor I0.1. To solve this issue, we will insert another branch in the network too. We will insert the normal open contact of the start bit M0.0. Next, we will insert the normal open contact of the cam sensor I0.1. Next, we will copy and paste the timer T1 into this new branch. We can change the timer to T2. Now it is an individual timer working. Next, we will link a branch from the output of the timer to the output Q0.1. As you can see that, now we have two conditions. Number 1, if the conveyor belt stops when the rotating cam is not in front of the sensor I0.1, it will activate the timer T1, and after 5 seconds, T1 will set the alarm bit Q0.1. Condition number 2 is that if the conveyor belt malfunctions and cam is in front of the sensor I0.1, this time the timer T2 will get activated, and after 5 seconds it will activate the timeout alarm. So next we will download the program into the PLC and monitor it and see how does it works. Now we will start the process by pressing the push button I0.3. As the box comes in front of the sensor I0.0, the conveyor starts and box starts to move forward on the belt. Now as the conveyor belt malfunctions and stops, as you can see that the cam is not in front of the sensor I0.1. As we have used the normal close contact of I0.1 PLC input, it will start the timer T1, and after 5 seconds it will activate the alarm output Q0.1. Now we will reset the alarm bit by activating the reset bit M0.1. Now let's test the second condition. We will start the process by pressing the push button I0.3. As soon as the box comes in front of the sensor I0.0, the conveyor belt motor starts. As the conveyor belt stops, and as you can see that this time the cam is in front of the sensor I0.1. This time the T2 timer starts via normal open contact of the sensor I0.1. After 5 seconds the T2 timer will activate the output Q0.0, which is our alarm buzzer. Now we have solved the problem in the ladder logic. If you want to download this project, the link is in the description box. That's the end of today's tutorial, and it's time to say goodbye. Please do share, like and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get notified for the new video tutorials. Next time, take care and goodbye.